Baker's triumphant BET Awards performance, L. DeBarge's new album, Second Chance, is one of the most anticipated albums of the year. Oh, L. DeBarge, Second Chance, in stores now.
I got to spend some time with my beautiful daughter, Idris, and she came up with this idea. She wants to put a family reunion together with them. I haven't seen a lot of them in years.
I don't remember the last family reunion. It's been a long time.
You know what I want to see? I want to see Uncle James. I want to see Uncle Norman. I want to see Aunt Mamie, Uncle Bobby, all the people that make me laugh.
Yep.
You give Grandma a picture, it's going straight on the computer.
Oh, don't give her a picture. Unless he wants the world to see
it. Oh, my God.
Yeah. When I tell people my grandmother's on Facebook, they're like, what? Your grandmother? How old is your grandmother?
Oh, like, hey, you remember?
It doesn't matter.
Do you remember they used to have, this was when you were a kid. I don't know if you remember.
What?
Rapping Granny?
No, what's
they
that?
They had a grandma that was rapping. She
what?
Was called the Rapping Granny.
No. No, I don't remember that.
Today is a big day. I'm going to go meet with Ron Fair, the chairman of Geffen Records.
I'm taking my daughter, Drees, over to Interscope to meet Ron Fair. This should be interesting. This will be the first time me and my daughter have really spent some real business time together.
What's up, buddy?
Ron, how are you?
Hi, I'm Ron Fair.
Hi, Drees. Nice to meet you, Ron.
Hey, Ron, how you doing, man?
I don't want no handshake. That's right. Ron Fair is not only a great producer, songwriter, musician, but he's also the chairman of the record label that I'm signed to, Interscope Geffen.
You're a music guy, Pete, and you're an A&R man, dyed in the wool, but like this DeBarge music is like part of your DNA, part of your soul. Like,
yeah.
What your reason for doing all this is because of how you felt as a kid when you heard.
I seen
DeBarge,
him the first time,
right?
When I was 16.
Because I understand what it does when it galvanizes your life.
Yeah.
So this is like a real honoring of not just L, but of the muse. Like what inspires you to
exactly,
and how you've seen this thing through is really unbelievable. It's like you get the Brotherhood Award of the decade.
I'm just so honored for you to have seen, you know, the vision I had seen.
I just want to make it the best it can possibly be, you know, under my watch, so that I know that when it goes out and the final decision is the customer, the person who loves music, that what they're deciding, whether they love it or not, is the best possible thing they could have decided.
Gotcha.
They're not hearing a half-cooked record or a half-mixed record or a half-written song or we did this record, but you know, we didn't take enough time. Like, I have to eliminate all that. I have to make sure that when it goes out, it's like it's going to either live or die on its own. And from the response that we've been getting, you know, whether it was 50 Cent jumping on a song or the promotion department freaking out or even Jimmy Iovine coming in here and saying, you know, you guys can do this, it's the goodwill coming towards you is so awesome. It's so emboldening. It's like I never seen anything like it, where there's so much goodwill. Like, everybody really wants you to be this L. DeBarge, this one that you are today.
I'm grateful. It really feels good to know that Ron Fair has such confidence in me. We all agreed that I will do a surprise performance on BET, 10th Annual Award Show.
Whew, man, I got butterflies. I just found out from Ron Fair that L is going to perform in front of 100 million viewers. I am really scared right now.
Can't wait. I can't wait, man. That's going to be so exciting and so scary. I mean, I'm singing live for the first time in a long time on TV in front of millions of people.
Have you seen him perform like in national TV? Or,
no.
You know? So this is good.
No.
This is your second chance, and your daughter gets to see you.
Yeah.
You know? It's big.
Mm-hmm. It's huge.
This is the first time Drees, my oldest daughter, is going to see me perform on TV live. That's just one more reason I got to pull it off right. It's kind of hard balancing work and family, especially when you have different mothers to all of your children, such as I have.
We're moving out here, and you're going to be very busy, okay? And I just, they're starting to talk about you more and more. More and more every day.
Well, Monica and I, we have a really, really interesting relationship because we're friends still.
At this point, it's important that it just continues on. You know, there's nothing like getting the carpet pulled up from under your feet.
Well, no, you want it to continue on, right?
I do.
Well, so do I. I mean, what's the problem? It ain't gonna be no problem.
Well, let me tell you, for one, our communication needs to be better. Definitely better. More open. That's what I want.
Okay, you got it.
Without being all in your coffee, all in your mix. You seem guarded. You seem a lot more guarded to me than you used to be.
Well, you know, it depends on what you're referring to. Are we talking about a relationship with my children? I'm not guarded.
No, I just mean simply picking up the phone and calling.
I have been busy in the studio trying to finish up this album and in and out of meetings every day. I do appreciate that you've been patient with me, and I do appreciate you keeping my name in my boy's ears. Mm-hmm. Now, I can tell you've been doing that because whenever they see me, they embrace me.
Yeah,
I appreciate
up.
That. So, you know, I'm going to do my part, you know, and because we family, man. I'm going to do my part. And I want to raise my children.
Okay.
Yeah. All right? So you could ride on me now, okay? All right? Who banging on me? Hi, can I come in?
Yeah, you can come in.
When I get into the studio, it's kind of like when I'm on stage. I go into a zone, and I'm in a sort of upper realm.
Love recording in the studio. I love writing songs. I love the whole recording process.
Okay, you ready for me? Okay, I'm going.
I've been known to sleep in studios. Music is just a feeling to me, and I'm always feeling something. So there's always an inspiration.
Baby, it says if you drop down from heaven.
I like to begin my songwriting process with sitting at the piano, and that way I can critique and develop what it is that I'm hearing.
You want to match it? You want to start from the beginning of the song? Just, okay. We're going to match the emotion here.
You're going to have a click that's going to start right at the beginning of the high note.
Mishka's another great songwriter that I've been collaborating with. He came over, called him up, said, Mishka, needs your expertise.
Serenading you.
This album, I've been working on it very hard. What I've gone through, struggles, the trials, the joys, the pains, the ups, the downs, and being given a second chance is so important. So let's do it. Join me.
Pete called his brother Jamal Farmer up, who is my trainer, and me and Jamal finna get busy out there in the park, do some sit-ups, some push-ups, just get it together.
So you guys ready? Let's do this. Make it happen. And what we're going to do first, we're going to get up here, we're going to warm up, come back down, do it a couple times, and we're going to stretch it out a little bit. You guys ready? All right, let's roll. So we'll do a real slow, nice little warm-up pace.
I just want to be able to take my shirt off, man, and not get laughed at. My mom used to have to go to Kmart, get me some gym shoes. They used to call them slip and slide specials. That's all you can slip and slide all across the basketball court. It's different working out here than it was when I was in prison.
Try to get as far
I really
as...
had a chance to do this on y'all.
Oh, yeah.
Because it was always packed.
Oh, yeah.
Man, everybody was on knees.
On knees.
Yeah. Because in prison, you always have to watch your back.
That's the knockout right there.
They didn't have no legs.
Yeah.
They never worked on their legs, but they was always on these dips.
Yeah, stilts. Two, you on the yard now, L. You on the yard. Keep your head up.
There you go.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah. Good job. A1, man. Let's keep A1, it pushing.
All right.
Good job.
All right.
Good job.
All right.
Good job.
Yeah.
Good job. That's how we do it. All right.